Hey everybody, it's Elliot from My Online Car Guy 1. Today we are going to show you how to wire up toggle switches that have the lit LED, which are generally three-prong switches. Okay, I'm going to show you how this works, why it works, and the way to do it. Let's go ahead and let's get into it now. If you are already a subscriber to the channel, thank you for coming back. Hopefully I can help you out with some more stuff. If you are new to the channel, welcome. Click the subscribe button. The link's down below in the corner. We plan on keeping them coming. Hopefully, you know, we can show you how to do a lot of these things you guys are doing on a daily basis. And not just show you how to do it, but help you to understand exactly why you're doing it this way. And then you won't need YouTube anymore. Or maybe you will. Either way, you'll be a fan. Hopefully. All right, let's go. Now, first things first, not all toggle and rocker switches that have LED are going to look like this. So these are both stationary switches. When I hit it, it'll stay in the on position and that's it. When I shut it off, it'll be in the off position and that's it. There are others that are momentary, which means that they're only on while the button is in and then it's off released and then vice versa. That part doesn't really change the electrical of a three-prong LED lighted switch. That part doesn't matter as far as how the switch itself functions. It's more about the electrical here behind this. This is the sweet sauce. This is what I'm going to help you guys with right here on the famous dry erase board. So to start off, we're going to do a short recap of how a toggle switch works. Essentially, you have a power source, okay? And you have a toggle switch. And then we're just going to do a light bulb here. Okay, we're just going to call this your device. Okay, so what you're trying to install is a toggle switch to your power supply to turn on and off a device. It doesn't necessarily have to be a light bulb. It very much can be an alarm contact or maybe another LED. Maybe it's not like a light bulb for the house, but it's a motor or an engine or something that you need to put an on-off switch. So I'm going to show you the basic electrical to get the toggle switch up and running, and then I'm going to show you the variable which introduces that third prong and why everybody is so quickly confused about that part. So in starting off, we're going to say power would normally go right to your light bulb. We're going to take the toggle switch out of the equation real quick to keep this simple, okay? So what you should already know is that you need power and ground to turn your light bulb on, right? So that's what it's going to require for your light or LED or whatever your device is, your device. I'm going to keep saying the light bulb, but your device. And now we want to introduce our toggle switch or a toggle switch to flick this light on and off. Okay, generally speaking, a toggle switch, a typical two-prong toggle switch, has two legs on it, okay? The way that this gets introduced into the circuit is it doesn't go with one leg on positive and one leg on negative, okay? Because if you did that, when you flip the switch, you will have a genuine electrical short, just like that. That's when everything burns and breaks and fuses pop. And nothing but bad things happen. And then you end up on YouTube asking me how to wire this up. So first off, don't do that. Secondly, if you've already done that, I would love to know what happened. Comment in the comment section below and just let me hear the tales of you know, what cooked, what smoked, what happened. Because those are always fun stories, hopefully. Not overly expensive and everybody was safe. So with all that said, do not do that, okay? The way that your toggle switch gets introduced to the circuit electrically, okay, is that we have to break a connection. Either we have to break connection in positive or break connection in negative. So what I mean by that is if we know already that for this bulb to light up, we need power and we need ground, and we have power and we have ground from our battery or wherever our power supply is coming from, you already know if you disconnect power, what happens to the bulb? obviously the bulb stops working. So we know if you disconnect power, the bulb will stop working. And then if you reconnect the power, the bulb will turn back on. So we know what happens with the power leg. If we go and we disconnect the ground, then what happens? If you don't have the ground on the light bulb, guess what? The light's not gonna work, right? So these are things you already know. You already know you need power and ground. The reason that I'm reminding you is because this is where the toggle switch comes in. Under the context that if you take off power, the light shuts off, it won't work, or you take off the ground and the light doesn't work, that's important to understand, not just know, but understand, because when we put our toggle switch into the circuit, I don't like that. Let's go with the blue. There we go. When you put your toggle switch in the circuit, you cut one leg. Remember earlier I said don't connect to red and black. Don't connect to positive and negative. What you do is you take one leg, and you cut it. And your toggle switch will go like that. So your power will go into the toggle switch on one leg and out on the other leg. Okay, and what happens is when you flip this toggle switch off, what it does is it disconnects the power inside. And what does that mean? That means we don't have power, which means our bulb is off. That's how a toggle switch works. With that said, we just said, and you know, I like to think you guys agree with me, that if we take the negative leg off of the light bulb, if we take that off, then the light also stops working. So what that means is that electrically, we can also put the toggle switch here. See that? On one leg for our device. That way, when you shut the toggle switch off, it disconnects internally. And what happens? Absolutely right. Our device turns off. So it doesn't matter which side you put it on, whether it's the power side or the ground side. The important thing to know here is that your toggle switch input and output is on one leg, not across the terminals, okay? When you're going across the terminals, the power and ground, that's when everything fries. So now that we have recapped exactly how our device works, and exactly how a typical toggle switch works, now we're gonna go ahead and introduce our LED lit toggle switch, which has more than the two prongs. It has three prongs on it. Now you can't see that. I'll show you again in a second. So let's go ahead, let's take this out. Just for simplicity's sake, we're gonna start this one off on our positive leg, okay? So what we have, we can pick which one do you guys want? You want the big one, the big green? Yeah, let's do the big green one. That's a very obvious that lights up versus this one. So here what we have is a three-prong switch. I'm gonna show you exactly, in this case, what is written on it. See if we can't get that to, there you go. There, you see that? It says earth, load, and supply. What that means is that each of these prongs, one of them is earth, which means ground, one of them is load, which means device, and the other one is supply. So under that context, we have supply, earth, load, okay? So the way that this toggle switch is gonna wire up is quite simple. We have supply. Right? I will just call that prong one. Then we have our device, which is our electrical load. Okay? And then finally, we have, what was our third one here? What is it? Earth, load, and supply. Okay. So we have earth, load, and supply. So we have load, supply, and then our last one is earth. This one is the one that is slightly different. That we're going to call prong three. So we have prong one, two, and three. So essentially, what we are looking at are the three contact points of the toggle switch. Now, electrically, all you're going to see is three prongs off the toggle switch. But if I take this, okay, and we zoom in on it, what's happening is inside the toggle switch, we're going to try to draw you a giant toggle switch. Okay, inside the toggle switch, we have what would be an output and an input, okay, which are generally both positive, and then a ground. The reason for this is because internally, we have this LED, right? So not only are we trying to, now keep in mind, this isn't connected here. This is just my zoomed in toggle switch, like our internals of the toggle switch. Internally, what happens is, if this is power, right? And we're putting all of this on the power leg, then we have voltage coming in and going out, okay? Which wired up this way means we have voltage coming in and going out to our device. Remember our diagram earlier? Now our light bulb or our LED within the toggle switch has its own little prongs built in the toggle switch, okay? So this is just a toggle switch. This is an LED lit toggle switch. So what that means is that this extra ground needs to come in to power or to ground our negative leg for this LED. And then internally on the toggle switch, it connects to the LED. So when you flip this switch on, internally, it lets this power connect, which sends power to the LED and allows power to pass through. So if this is your three-prong toggle switch, like this, that's what it is. You see that? You have three legs. You have an input leg and an output leg, which is just getting power from our source to device. And then within that, there's the LED, which needs to be powered. It needs to have its own power and ground. So essentially, this circuit now has two devices, because you have the device you're actually trying to power, right? But then within your toggle switch, you have another LED, which is just another device. So now you have a device within a device. If we crack this open and look at what happens inside, this is all that happens. You have one power source that comes in, which this is our doorway of, you know, we'll say open. Or closed. Or even more so. So it's less confusing. We're going to say on and off. So what happens here is when the toggle switch is flipped on, this connects. It lets the power come through. When it comes through, it feeds power to our LED, which we have a ground, that was our third prong, and it passes the power through onto the rest of our device here. Okay, so what I'm going to do real quick, just to kind of speed this up, is I'm going to wipe this off. We're going to bring our zoomed in toggle switch here, just in case somehow I'm not making things clear. Alrighty. I want to start from scratch for you. You have a device, you have your power, okay? You need to take your positive leg here, cut your wire, One needs to go into the toggle switch. One's going to come out of the toggle switch. Now, with this part, for the third leg, this is an additional ground. You can tap your wire, or you can get it straight from the source, okay? That part doesn't matter as long, we're just gonna do or. That or that, okay? Either way, these are grounds, okay? Then your toggle switch, zoomed in, works quite simply. We have our power going into the switch. We have our power coming out of the switch. We have a ground, for conversational sake, goes into the switch, okay? In a typical toggle switch, all this does is power comes in, into the toggle switch, is told right here, on, off, right? And what that does is it opens and closes this little electrical doorway, which just does that. So without this ground here, this is a typical toggle switch. An LED lit toggle switch, which is what you guys are all here for, takes this ground and it supplies a power and ground for our LED. So what internally inside of the toggle switch, what happens is this power feed that comes in on the back side of the open and close portion of the switch, the mechanical side, powers your device. Power and ground. You see that? So that's how it works internally. So as far as wiring up your switch, what you need to understand are these three prongs. You have an input, an output, and a common ground. Now, unfortunately, not all toggle switches have little labels on them, okay? That's where things get more complicated, is when you end up with a three-prong switch like this that has no label, no nothing, it tells you nothing as far as the prongs. So the only information you have is you can see that one tooth is a gold. I don't know if I can get this to focus. But the one tooth there is a gold. You know, so that's a little bit of indication that that one is slightly different. Now, the way to test as far as your prongs and your which pin is input versus output versus ground, there's really the only way that I do it is by starting with identifying the two pins that have continuity. When I flip the switch, those are my inputs and outputs, right? Because we already know that our input and output is connected. So when I put a multimeter or a tool on here searching for continuity, then when I flip this switch, it'll go beep, because that means that this portion here inside the toggle switch is connected, which means that this and this are now connected inside, that it is passing through, or it's in a pass-through position. So I'm gonna try to show you that here. Let's see how well this goes. So we're gonna take our prongs here. I set my meter for continuity, and in this case, the one that has the little speaker audible output. So when the meters connect and there's continuity or connection, it beeps. So we're gonna set that over there, this on, and we're gonna meter or check continuity between this pin and this pin, okay? The two outer pins, and flip the switch. Nothing. So what that means is that these two pins are not the pair that is my input and output. So now I'm gonna switch to the middle pin. That's a good sign, is beeping. See, that's off, on, off, on. Okay, so far I have tested my outer pins to figure out which is input and output. And then I've tested center pin and pin one over here And I got continuity here. So right now it says that most likely this is my pass through. But just to be sure, I'm going to test the gold pin, or pin 3, and the center pin. Yep, and there's no continuity there. So what that means is that the two pins here, which is pin 1 and pin 2, there's continuity. Which means when I flip the switch, it passes through. Which essentially means that pin 1 and 2 is this guy, which is input and output. Now on a toggle switch, that side does, it doesn't matter which is which. And we discussed that earlier. It's just about breaking the circuit and closing, opening and closing the circuit, and that's it. So based on the meter and the fact that there's no labels here, what that means is that these two silver prongs are my pass-through for our main device, which then means that this last prong, this copper prong, is our third, our additional ground to activate our LED. So in this case, the way that I would wire this up was that would be that our feed, or pin 1 here, would be our input is one of the little silver prongs. This one is also a silver prong, and this one is the little gold prong. And under that context, that's how this one would have worked based on the continuity check on these pins. So even though in my diagram I split it this way, according to this toggle switch and the meter here and that setting, the little continuity setting there, that is how that works. So hopefully that helped you guys out. I myself am a huge fan of trying to help any of you guys out with anything that I can. So if the video didn't help you, or you're still stuck with a couple of questions, or you have some crazy switch that this three prong isn't going to cover, leave a message below and ask me. Me and the guys here at the shop are very, very active on our YouTube channel and trying to help everybody out. Now, sometimes we get the messages with a bit of delay. You know, just hang in there. For the most part, we have YouTube, the apps and stuff on the phone, some of the company phones. So when the messages come through, you know, I think we get them relatively quick. We try to answer as fast as possible. But don't be afraid to drop a question down there or tell me if we helped you guys out. Tell me what you guys are working on. Like, oh my God, this is great. I figured it out. The LED deal, used a multimeter, and now my, you know, AI robot, you know, can do bench presses or whatever it is you're doing. I'd love to know what your guys' projects are. So let me know what you're working with. Hopefully we helped you guys out. Please like the video. It lets me know that we're being helpful or we're not being helpful. And then any comments, any questions, anything I can help you guys out with, drop the message down below. Thanks.